And then to the person who is neophyte and engaged in archery, he thinks he has certain characteristics. So Shunakura is giving an example to illustrate this. He thinks, oh my good day is coming, what should I do? I'll make a very big gate to welcome him. And then I'll decorate the whole temple. You'll be so pleased by this. And then Gurudev comes. And when his Gurudev comes, he never thinks whether his Gurudev is hot or cold or whether he's hungry or tired or anything. The first thing he does is he brings him inside and sits him on a massive throne. He makes a big throne. And then putting him on the throne, then he brings a holy paraphernalia and starts ringing the bell and offering arts to his Gurudev. So then he gets a big bundle of incense and lights them all and almost kills his Gurudev with a sword. And then he's offering arts and the arts is going on and on and on without any end. And his Gurudev is thin and cold, but the disciple thinks in art, when you offer arts, you have the fan. So he gets a big fan and starts fanning his Gurudev, who's already so cold.
Guru said that, oh, I don't need fan. What all this is belief. I must do this.
And then he takes a toast leaf and keeps it in the hand of his Gurudev. And then at the end of it, Arti, then he takes a big conch shell and blows the conch shell. And everyone who's watching, they become struck with wonder and think, oh, what an amazing Guru Seva. But actually, this is great.
In the
same
example of those who are in the mix, middle of Acharya Gurudev hotels and Hari Bhakti, you should eat him. But how would they be eat? Let us complete all this.
So then, in comparison to this, in juxtaposition to this, Gurudev is saying, what is Vishwambhava? What is the natural and intimate mood of love and affection? The disciple is watching his Gurudev and thinking, is his mouth dry? Does he need a glass of water? Is he cold? How should he be more comfortable? How can I make him happy? What is his vichar? What are his deep considerations? In this kind of service, there's no space for any bells, no bell ringing. So Archan is Mariyada Purva, following very strictly all the rules. So Gurudev is getting the conclusion that most devotees, they never served their Gurudev. They never served him. Why? Because really they do Archan to Guru. They don't, Gurudev said that most, they don't even know the meaning of Guru Seva, or what is the fragrance of Guru Seva. And they serve their Gurudev in such a way, they do Archan, but actually they make him become angry. So then Gurudev described that at the end of Bhajan Rahasya, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has given Archan Padati, or an explanation of the method by which one should practice Archan. So this is necessary. Without observing this, in according to the Adhikar, then one will not be able to enter into Uttam Bhakti. But the Archan Padati that is given in the book is very small. It's a very condensed Archan Padati, just to meet the requirements of Archan. So, in Bhajan Rahasya, he's not putting any emphasis on this. Where is he putting emphasis? He's showing the confidential process, how to really do Bhajan in such a way that Radha and Krishna will be pleased and satisfied. And in Bhajan Rahasya, the process has been given how to become completely immersed and become drowned in the ocean of Bhakti Rasa. Someone who is following Archan, they cannot read this book Bhajan Rahasya and they have no taste in it. But those who want to know how to enter into the ocean of Rasa, then they must read this book Bhajan Rahasya. The process of Archan is mixed with the conception which is related to the gross and subtle body. So in this world there must be. But bhajan, when bhajan is practiced, then this bhajan is totally beyond any connection with the gross and subtle not by this body. Bhajan is performed by the Atma. This is speciality bhajan. It is performed by the soul. And it is performed by the soul who is established in Sambandha Jnana, knowledge of a relationship with Krishna. He will think, oh, I am the friend of Krishna. Krishna is my child. Krishna is my friend. Krishna is my dear most beloved. So Srila Gaurav was giving some examples from the Kirtans of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Purvat itihasa bulinu sakala seva sukhavaiva mani amito tomar tumito amakita de apane nai. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, since I have absorbed myself in bhajan, in your seva, then I have completely forgotten all of my previous history. I don't know who I am, where I am, what I am, all these material things, I've forgotten completely. All I know is that I am yours and you are mine. There is no need of anything else. And then Srila Gurudev quoted another kirtan of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Rekite, rekite, uliko bhakamai, mitis kulamai chai. When will that day come when all of a sudden I will become completely oblivious to my material identity? When will I think? I am a gopi. I am a follower of Rupa Manjari. And then Srila Gurudev is again comparing this with the conception of someone who is on the path of Archan. As a joke, Srila Gurudev was speaking about Srila Bhaktivedanta Chaturmaraj. Afterwards he explained, this is a joke, no one should think like this. But as an example, he's saying, someone might think, my name is what my name used to be, such and such a brahmachari, and I am being Archan. But now I am no longer a brahmachari, now I am a sannyasi. So, with these ideas, one cannot do bhajan. The Kanishka Adhikari is bound to think like this, and he's bound to follow the path of Archan. But this Archan should be performed along with kirtan. What kind of kirtan? Then Srila Gurudev was giving some examples. Jai Jai Radha Krishna Dukalamilan. And especially, he was giving the example of one kirtan written by Paramujabhad Srila Bhaktivinoda Dhirigram Maharaj. In this kirtan, he's written about offering arti to Srila Bhakti Pradyan Keshi Goswami Maharaj, his beloved Gurudev. And in this kirtan, he's described how all the most intimate disciples of Srila Bhakti Pradyan Keshi Maharaj, and not only his disciples, but intimate associates also, like Narahari Prabhu, how they are offering arti with Shamar, how they are doing kirtan.
Yes.
In this, well, there are two kirtans. One.
Guru Maharaj has done half the option of Prabhupada. In that, we have to
be in the kirtan, written by Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshava Maharaj, describing the arts of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, he has written about Narahari Prabhu worshipping Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur. And in another example, Paramujabhad Bhaktivinoda Dhirigram Maharaj has given the example of the disciples of Srila Pragyan Keshava Maharaj, such as Srila Bhaktivinoda Bhava Maharaj and our Gurudev and others, how they're offering arti. So one should not think that their offering of arti and the offering of arti by a Kanishka Adhikari who is on the path of Archan are the same. Don't equalize these two things. It would be a great offense. And the Dhirigram Maharaj is commented that this, he's saying about himself, in his humility, of this fallen person is standing very far away and watching his very qualified Bhagavadas doing arti to his Gurudev. So Gurudev is commenting, what a very excellent kirtan Srila Dhirigram Maharaj has written. So Srila Gurudev is saying that those who have no connection with the material body, they may engage in the external activities of Archan, but don't commit the offense of thinking that their activity and the activity of the Kanishka Adhikari of Archan is the same. Srila Gurudev commented that Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written, I am in the Guru Srimati Radharani. Vrishamanu Kure Ganamaloyo Yava Vivahave. One should follow these moves of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. When will I take birth in the village of Vrishamanu Maharaj? And when I become somewhat older, when will my hand be offered in marriage? And I will marry a goat in the village of Jawat, where Srimati Radharani is living. So this is, we should take these bhavs and follow these moves of Bhakti Mukta Thakur. Should we give another example of how we cannot see from the external activities what is internally going on? The example is, once Srila Rupa Goswami passed, he was hearing Srila Bhagavatam. And upon hearing Srila Bhagavatam, he became completely absorbed. So when Srila Rupa Goswami passed, he's hearing the verses of Srila Bhagavatam, Harikatha, what is going on? Immediately, he enters into his identity and thinks, I am Rupa Manjari. And he begins the service, to render service to Srimati Radharani in his eternal transcendental form as Sri Rupa Manjari. At that time, Radharani is ordering her, Satoyam Navakshapunaraya Vayamaradanaya. Oh, Rupa Manjari, go and stand at the gate of Vaikunj, and you should guard this place and see that that cheating person, he doesn't come here. At that time, when Srila Rupa Goswami is hearing Srila Bhagavatam, he begins to smile. But why is he smiling? Because internally, in his form is Rupa Manjari. She is smiling. But outwardly, we can't understand what is going on. So this bhajan, it is free from all my heart. All material moods, all illusory, temporary conceptions, they're all outside of this. What is this? Those who are Mahapurush, when they become absorbed, they perceive the spiritual world and the activities there. Their perceptions are nothing to do with matter or the material world. Outwardly, any devotee may be making a garland, like Bhakti Rukmini would make some garlands, or he would get up in the middle of the night and begin cooking. But internally, what is he doing? He's thinking, I am serving Radha and Krishna. So don't think, if someone is in that high stage, when you see them, you should never think that anything that they're doing is material or has connection with this world. It is connected to their internal confidential life. So Srila Gurudev was quoted because of Guru Goswami, Vyatiti Bhavana Vakma, Yastamkara Bhavu, Rides Chite Satkujale Bhavam, Asudai Sarasomata. This is the definition of rasa given by Srila Guru Goswami Pad, in which he's saying that when the heart of the devotee becomes fully illuminated by Shuddha Sattva descending from the spiritual world, at that time he has such an astonishing experience. He tastes Bhakti Ras, and that experience is Vyatiti Bhavana Vartma. It is beyond all types of gross and subtle contemplations of the mind. So, then Srila Gurudev described, at that time he cannot understand who he is, or what he's doing, or what he's saying externally. So, this is called rahasya. When the guru gives very confidential and intimate instruction to that disciple who has served him heart and soul, he's coming to a high stage and he's very intimate. Then, just as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given all these things to Guru Goswami, Sanatana Goswami and others, the guru, he gives his confidential instructions on the method of bhajan, how to enter into this confidential realm. This method is called rahasya. So this is the explanation of the meaning, bhajan rahasya, given in the preface of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur.
उसको इस शब्द उसको माना था मुझे तो वो राधा कृष्ण की जीवन से बाद में उनको जरा मिले उसमें बात है बाबा जी ने क्या समझ लिया ये हमको रमण मंदिर का और हमारे ईश्वर ये सेवा ये सब भजन रहस्य
गुरुदेव
अभी हम ऊपर मुझे हमारे पक्रेश्वर ने बहुत सुंदर कीर्तन किया हमारी इच्छा में कि हम चले रहे भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर जी भजन करते समय का वो फील कर रहे
गुरु महाराज देशक गुरु सेवन सद्धर्म शिक्षा सर्व महाराज गुरुमान Now, first of all, take shelter of the lotus feet of bona fide guru and Vishnambhena Guru Seva. Serve the one spiritual master with a mood of intimacy, like accepting him as one's dearest friend and guide. And Gradually one will become free from Maya. And what you do? Sadhumarjanagaman. Follow the path which has been delineated by sadhus and those who are facing bhajan. How? Sankhya Puro Kanam Gandhati Tavasani Kito Nidra Hara Vihara Kari Kito Satyanta Dino Cheyo Radha Krishna Gunesh Mithi Vandre Mara Kena Samohito Vandre Rupi Snatmur Prabhu Yugo Siji Gopalavo. Chanting fixed number of rounds like our Goswamis, Gopinath and others. Giving Dandavat Pranam, fixed number every day. Singing so many kirtans, dancing. Controlling the eating, reducing the sleeping. Always being very meek and humble. And internally remembering the many form qualities and pastimes of Radha and Krishna. So, if one will adopt this process of serving Gurudev and following the previous acharyas, then by their mercy, then the asakali lila of Radha Krishna will gradually awaken within the heart of the disciple, easily. So then Gurudev is warning, don't associate with those who commit offenses. Don't associate with those who are averse to Shuddha Bhakti. Don't associate with those who have no taste in Hari Katha and in Hari Nam, and those who have no faith in this path of bhajan, those who have anyabhilas, material desires, and they are addicted to karma, fruitive activities, and jnana, mental speculation, and the desire for liberation. Don't associate with them, otherwise you cannot enter these things. Then finally, Shri Gurudev is giving an example of what is Mahasya from the beginning of Jaiva Dharma. We see in the beginning of Jaiva Dharma, one sannyasi, he's from Mayavadi sannyasi, coming from Kashi. He comes to Navadvipa, and then he takes shelter of his Gurudev, and he serves it. So one morning, his Gurudev is sitting and chanting, and remembering, deeply absorbed in bhajan. All of a sudden, he spoke, "Hey, Ramanandari, the monkey of Shrimadhyayaka, Kakati, is making such a noise and disturbing Radha and Krishna, so you should silence that monkey." So this is called Rahasya. The Guru, he gives these things to his disciple, his identity and service, and in this way, his eternal constitutional service becomes awakened. Now, Krishna Guru, Guru point here then.
Artan Shamaya. कपड़े नहीं पहना, फल दिखाया और बड़ी कठोरता से शास्त्र के तीन के मंत्रों से घंटा बजाता हुआ बोला था, है पंडित की दुस्साहसी, किंतु ये भयंकर जो है, ये भाई बड़ा बड़े, बिना गुरु जी के, बिना शब्दों की कृपा के ये नहीं हो सकता। वो भाग ही नहीं आएगा आचरण हम लोग कर लेंगे कठोर दया के साथ में या जैसे हमारे जा सकते हैं तीन भी जा सकते हैं ये सब तो हो सकता है किंतु वो भावना कहाँ से आएगी भाई इस भावना से हम कृष्ण के प्रति लौकिक सत्व भाव होकर के उनकी सेवा करें तब भय की लिखा दो भाषा नीचे भी कर But he can do it from reading from books, or he can recite all months and do duty and then it be done. But no cost, nothing, no cost, we can go. But bhajan of without me, a special mercy of good and you can easily the service of Astakati is done. From where you will have love and affection for you, Arathani. Gurudev may be a priesty Muna ki kaise sabha hai bhai. Vina Vishnu ke kripa ke. Radha Krishna Mamata kaam chahi. From where you will collect. Oh, no Mamata nothing you can do us. No other. Manishma Adhikari hai no Mamata hai. But in this, Mamata hai. ममता अपन तो ममता को कहां से लाएगा नहीं बड़ी कृपा की जरूरत है. We need त्यागो I have to be godless mercy of you without so it is very difficult. हाँ जरा
जो
Yeah. Namami Swaram Sachidananda
Oh, So Peace. Srinivasan, Mr. Bharat, Mr. Shaman, 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 Mr.
समस्त अनुष्ठानों में मंगलाचरण होना चाहिए।
इसकी विधि है मंगलाचरण। सबसे पहले यदि नमामि ईश्वरम है तो एक बात इससे प्रकट होती है, नमस्कार कर रहे हैं तो अपने आराध्य के प्रति दास्य भाव नहीं रहने से प्रणाम नहीं हो सकता है, सख्य भी नहीं है, बात्सल्य भी नहीं, मधुर की तो बात नहीं। इसलिए मालूम होता है कि ये दास्य भक्ति से आरंभ करना है और इसलिए मंगलाचरण में नमामि इस पद का प्रयोग करते हैं। इसलिए प्रणाम कर रहे हैं, सनातन गोस्वामी जी बतला रहे हैं। अब उनके हृदय में जो भाव है सो तो है ही है, शब्द प्रत नहीं, सनातन गोस्वामी उसमें और भी चार चांद लगाते हुए बतला रहे हैं। किसको नमस्कार? नमामि ईश्वर, ईश्वर को, जो सर्वशक्तिमान है ईश्वर। कर्तुम अन्यथा कर्तुम सर्वकर्तुम समर्थ, ये ईश्वर है। नो नहीं होने वाला है उसको भी कर ले, जो होने वाला है उसको भी अन्यथा कर सकते हैं, उसको जो होने वाला है उसको भी अन्यथा कर देंगे, उनके लिए कोई भी चीज असंभव नहीं। जगत के जो ईश्वर है अथवा ईश हमारे प्रभु हैं, उनको नमस्कार है। ये तीन अर्थ दिया, सर्वशक्तिमान, जगत के एकमात्र ईश्वर और हमारे प्रभु, ये तीन अर्थ दिया। पहले पक्ष में सर्वशक्तिमान, इसका बोलने का हेतु है कि हमें स्तुति शक्ति लाभ, मैं स्तुति कर सकूं। जैसे कि ध्रुव की इच्छा थी, भगवान ने शंख स्पर्श करा दिया तो वो जब बोलने लगते, ऐसे मुझको सुंदर अपनी स्तुति को अभिव्यक्ति की शक्ति हमारे अंदर में प्रदान की। इसे मालूम होता है कि उनके अंदर में कुछ भावना है, इसलिए अपने ईश्वर को जो प्रसन्न करना चाहते हैं वो कैसे प्रसन्न होंगे? समस्त जगत का, जगत के नियंता है, सृष्टि करता है, ब्रह्मा इत्यादि के भी तुत्य है, ये कहने से प्रसन्न होंगे ना ब्रजवासियों के साथ में उनका संपर्क रख करके स्तुति करें, अपने सखाओं के जूठा खाने वाले हैं। उधर में वो वर्णन किया ये जगत के सृष्टि करने वाले ईश्वरों के भी ईश्वर के परमेश्वर हैं और अपने सखाओं के जूठा खाने वाले हैं प्रभु आप। यशोदा मैया जिसके कमर में रस्सी बांध देती है, ऐसे ही ये प्रभु और गोपियों के चरण में अपने को बिक्री करने वाले हैं प्रभु, तब उस पीछ में प्रसन्न अधिक होंगे। इसलिए स्तुति करने की शक्ति कर्मशक्ति, जब मैं उनको ऐसे प्रसन्न करूं कि वो प्रसन्न हो जाए तो वो प्रसन्न होंगे ब्रज के जो भाव में उसके द्वारा, ऐसी हमको शक्ति दी और इसीलिए उन्होंने अंत में वैसे स्तुति की है। द्वितीय पक्ष में जगत के ईश्वर परम वंदनीय और अंत तृतीय पक्ष में हमारे प्रभु हैं, तात्पर्य क्या है? उनके प्रति विशेष भक्ति ज्ञापन कर रहे हैं। कैसे है? सच्चिदानंद रूप, सच्चित खन मूर्ति है। इसकी भी सनातन गोस्वामी ने बहुत जगहों में बहुत तरह की व्याख्या, हम लोग संक्षेप में चले, बहुत कष्ट तो किया है, इसलिए आगे और भी बढ़ेंगे। इसलिए तत्व की दृष्टि से यहां तक बदला है, अब यहां रूप के संबंध में, पहले उन्होंने कहा जो रूप माधुरी हमारे इष्ट देव की कैसे पहले तो धाम बताया वो गोकुल का संबंध में मैं बताया उस धाम में गोकुल प्रजमान सुशोभित होने वाले और बतलाया रूप के पक्ष में सौंदर्य विशेष का उत्कर्ष बतला बतला है कैसा सौंदर्य है इनका माता यशोदा के दौड़ते हुए सतत बाल्य पीड़ा विशेष हेतु निरंतर लोलता निबंधन जिनके गालों पर कपोलों पर मकर कुंडल पीड़ाशील हो जब कृष्ण जी भाग रहे हैं अपनी मैया के भाई से दौड़ रहे हैं तो कुंडल क्या कर रहे हैं उनके कपोलों को बड़े सुशोभित होकर के नृत्य कर रहे हैं इसके द्वारा मुख्य विशेष शोभा बतलाएंगे लसत कुंडलम इसके द्वारा अर्थ भी और भी होगा मकर कुंडल ये दोनों गंड अर्थात कपोल का चुंबन करने के लिए जिसको यशोदा मैया बार बार चुंबन करती हैं जिसको गोपियां चुंबन करती हैं आज इसका इतना सौभाग्य कि ये कपोलों को वो तो एक दो बार दिन में चार बार कर सकते हैं और ये सतत चुंबन कर रहा है इसलिए इनको सनातन गोस्वामी पाद के हृदय में कुछ ईर्ष्या होती है गोपियों को भी ईर्ष्या होती है और ये निरंतर इसका मुख चुंबन कर रहा है जब सूखी हुई बांस की एक पोर बंसी के प्रति ऐसी भावना तो फिर इसके प्रति क्या इसके द्वारा समस्त भूषणों का ही सौभाग्य विशेष उपलब्धि करा जितने कृष्ण के आभूषण है उनका सौभाग्य जैसे अंगद अंगद बने गए कृष्ण के यहाँ पर अनंत या अंगद बंधा रहता है अंग को देने वाले अंगद बहुत विशेष रूप में सनातन गोस्वामी ने अपनी टीकाओं में इसके अर्थ अंगद ऐसा है उसका कितना सौभाग्य है वो और दूसरों को तो आलिंगन करते हैं कृष्ण आता और अंगद क्या करता है सब समय बाहुओं को आलिंगन किया रहता है ऐसा उसका परम सौभाग्य देखा थे गोपियों को भी चीड़ होती है इससे इसलिए अंगद को चोरी कर लेती है यदि कहो ये अंग की शोभा ये बढ़ाते हैं तो ऐसा मत कर लो कृष्ण का उनका ऐसा है उनका कोई आभूषण न रहे केवल नंगे ही ढूंढ रहे हो तभी प्रसन्न यदि कोई काली लग जाती है धूल धूसरी धूस बाल बिंद हो जाता है तो और भी सुंदर लगते हैं उनको किसी आभूषणों की अपेक्षा नहीं इसलिए दशम स्कंद में ये कहा गया है त्रौलक्य सौभगम पितंजलिरूपम
Since so many years I have been hearing the explanation of these verses by Maharaj during this parikrama, but every time newness comes and again it appears absolutely in new way Gurudev is explaining. First verse, Namami Shwaram Sachidanand Rupam. As described by Sanatana Goswami, that explanation is coming to us now. The first verse is like Mangalacharan. In Mangalacharan, we pay obeisances to our worshipable. This is the system. So, Satyavart Muni, he is paying his obeisances to his worshipable, Krishna. So Gurudev is giving a very wonderful insight in this regard. There are three things he is saying about Krishna. Who is Krishna? Who has got such potency which can do anything, which can perform any activity? Anything which is impossible, Krishna can perform by his potency. So first he is presenting the potency of Krishna. His capacity to perform impossible tasks. Then, second thing, he is Ishwar. Ishwar means he is creator of whole universe. He is owner of whole universe. And he is all in all of this universe. So he is paying his obeisances to such Krishna. And the third thing, while he is describing him Ishwar, he has got three meanings in this. Number one, he has got the Krishna, who is Ishwar. He has got potency to do all the impossible tasks. Second, he is Lord of this world. And third, he is my Ishwar, means my Lord. So these three things he is uttering. He means to speak, he has three meanings when he says Ishwara and he is paying his obeisances to such Ishwara. Why? He is calling, number one, that you can do impossible tasks. Your potency is unlimited. So you kindly grant me some power so that I may also become somewhat capable to worship you or express my feelings to you so that you may be pleased. This shows that he has got some inner mood. This mood is very special mood and he is unable to express it, but he wants to express it. So he is rendering his prayer to Krishna that by your this extraordinary potency, inject some power in me. Just as Dhruv Maharaj, he was only 5 years old and he was unable to perform his worship, and then Narayan put his conch shell on his cheek, then he was able to utter and recite all the shlokas in appreciation of Lord. So he has got some inner mood to please Krishna. He wants to please Krishna. How can he please? One thing is very clear, if someone is paying his obeisances, doing pranam to his worshipable, that means he has got dasya bhava. He considers that my Lord is controller of everyone and I am his servant. This servitor mode makes one, forces one to pay his obeisances. But if one prays someone in, prays Krishna, in servitor mood, then will Krishna be pleased? How Krishna will be really pleased? Satyavrat Muni knows it, that by servitor mood, by dasya bhav, Krishna will not be pleased. How Krishna will be pleased? If somehow or other he can relate Krishna with Brajavasis, then Krishna can be pleased. If he can relate Krishna, then how Yashoda Ma is running after Krishna and Krishna is scared of Yashoda Ma? If he can say how Krishna is running after gopis and always in mood to serve gopis, if he somehow or other can say this thing, then Krishna will be pleased. This inner meaning he has got in his heart but is unable to express it. So he is praying to Krishna, please make me capable to express it. And when he prays it, finally in the last verse, he becomes able to express gradually all his inner mood. Secondly, he is accepting him as Lord, so he is paying his obeisances. And third, he is considering him as his Prabhu, as his Lord. So he is praying to Krishna. What does it mean? How he is praying? First he explained, yesterday we have already discussed, that Krishna, where is he residing? In Gokul Dham. What is Gokul Dham? Is already been explained yesterday. Now, Krishna's continence, Krishna's beauty is going to be explained here. What type of beauty he has got? Lasat Kundalam, Gokule Prajima. So Gokul has already been explained yesterday. And now, this beauty, what is the beauty of Krishna? He is having kundal, what you call it, earring? Earring in on his ear. These kundal are so much fortunate. Why fortunate? That when Krishna is running, these kundal are doing dances on the cheeks of Krishna as if continuously they are kissing Krishna's cheeks. How fortunate! Those cheeks which are being kissed by Yashoda Maiya, those cheeks which are kissed by gopis. Today, Kundal is continuously having this fortune to go on kissing them. They may kiss in a day, 2, 3, 4 times, but this Kundal is so fortunate. So gopis are having this enviousness in their heart. Oh, this Kundal. Why should not we become Kundal? So Sanatana Goswami is having this inner mood in his heart, and while he is explaining this fortune of Kundal, he is some or other expressing this mood, that is mood of gopis, that is mood of Radharani. Similarly, gopis are comparing this flute also, that had I been able to become flute. Why? Because flute has got such a nice and high class of fortune. These are the mood of gopis. Gurudev is saying, Krishna is having angad on his arm. What is angad? Angad that Krishna wears on his arm always embraces Krishna's arm. Which arms? For which gopis are having a great desire to be embraced. Gopis want that Krishna should put their arms around them. And those arms, Angad is embracing those arms, not one time, not two times, but continuously. How fortunate is this Angad? And gopis are having this envious feelings in their heart that had they been able to embrace this Angad, to become Angad. Now the question arises, these ornaments, which Krishna is wearing, how much they beautify Krishna. But frankly speaking, they don't beautify Krishna. They themselves are fortunate to be with Krishna. But Krishna is so much beautiful. Krishna's beauty is so high that it is not, it does not have any necessity to be decorated by any ornament. It is not like this. Krishna, when he is naked, fully naked, is most beautiful. And when some mud is or some any spot comes on his body anywhere, he becomes more beautiful. Why? Beauty is the asset of Krishna. And then Gurudev explained one verse here, he is going to explain it.
तारुप वर्णन करते हैं, रूप मात्र ही वर्णन करते हैं तेरी बोलते हैं। कृष्ण एक सारा पूर्णिमा है, वंशी बादल है, और सब गोपीरा आकृष्ट है, राष्ट्रीय जाति उपस्थित है। कृष्ण जब कुशल तुम्हारे लिए आर्मन कोई चीज़ हो, हमारे दर्शन कर ले तो, ऐसा तुम्हारा स्त्री धर्म हे पति जदि लंगड़ा लूढ़ा सब प्रकार अयोग्य हो पति प्रता स्त्री तार आदर करते सम्मान करते तार सेवा करते तुम्हारा बाड़ी फिर जाओ जदि मंगल जाओ बहुत धर्म में जुक्ति इत्यादि दिए एक बने थे एकांत थे एक स्थल थे निर्जन स्थल थे आशा अंची तो जा कमरा हमारे दर्शन करते बस बालू गए एवं पार्टी से वही समय गोपीराज ताकि की उत्तर दिए थे प्रत्युत्तर दिए थे काश रे उनके अरे हमारे स्त्री कथा की त्रिलोक सौभगमिदं च निरुच्छेदः तुम्हारे जेई देखबे तुम्हारे ए रूप आ तुम्हार बंशी वादन जारा सुनबे बंशी स्व एमन के जगते आछे त्रैलोक के जे त्रैलोक के शोभा स्वरूप सार स्वरूप तुम्हार ए रूप आ तुम्हार वंशी थाली श्रवण करे जद गो जावतीय समस्त पशु मध्य गाय के प्रधान गोरु बाजु हरि इत्यादि सब द्विज द्विज माने पाखी दुबार दुटा पाखी आछे पाखी तुम अरे मन की जड़ वृक्ष लता गुल्मय इत्यादि मृगा पुलकांड विभ्रम निजे धर्म विपरीत ना कर ताजे धर्म परिवर्तन ना हुई है हमारे धर्म जे परिवर्तन हो चाहे पति के शरीर दिए तुम्हारे निकटे से ची हमारे तो स्त्री जाति साधारण भाव और जहाँ ये सब उन्हीं जानवर पशु पक्षी मृग इत्यादि उधर ही धर्म परिवर्तन हो चाहे एमन की कुल कारण विभ्रम नदी तरह से ठीक हो जाए एवर कठिन जमे जाए आज कठिन जिस पाथर इत्यादि बिगड़े जाए ताजे धर्म परिवर्तन है जैसे हमारे धर्म परिवर्तन है जैसे देखिए आप सिर्फ जब कथा जब ये दोष आए तो हमारे दोष नहीं था दोष आए तो तुम्हारे के सुंदर रूपे दोष कृष्ण के कहने प्रत्युत्तर कर दिए ताकि तब तो कर दिलो सब एवं सुंदर रूप कृष्ण त्रयोग के सौभाग्य सौभाग्य अब फिर उद्धव द्वितीय स्कंद देते थे नहीं बोलते जन्मत्तली लोक जन्मत्तली लोकम स्वयोग माया बलम दर्शयिता गृहीतम भीष्माकरम स्वस्य च सौभगर्दे परम पदम भूषण सुभूषणम भीष्माकरम स्वस्य एवं रूप माधुरी ये अन्य लोगों की कथा कोई पशु पक्षी इत्यादि की कथा निजे ही निजे के देखे निजे ही तुम्हें मुक्त हो जाओ परम परम भूषण 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 परम फल परम सुंदर रूप एक थी क्या नारायण और द्वारकाधीश की रामचंद्र अत्यंत सुंदर किंतु ताहते को स्त्रीगण कृष्ण के रूप दर्शन करे मुक्त हो जाए ये पति प्रता छे काज ओ याचे जरा बोलचे द्विज पत्नी का पत्नी नंद जरा बोलचे ये लक्ष्मी देवता छेड़ दिए नारायण के आचोले आज लेने का एम भीष्मात्म अनुस्वस्त चल उद्धव अपन बोलचे कृष्ण प्रकट हो गए थे आचार्य ने बोले जी छे बद्रिकाश्रम जाओ आप बद्रिकाश्रम में प्रथे थे और विदुष संग देखा हुआ है कोई समय से कंतर करते 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 आते नहीं पड़े कुछ कृष्ण ने आज कृष्ण चले गए हमारा शून्य रहेगा भाई भीष्मात्म आज कथा की यही जो सुंदर जे कि जन्मत लीलो वैकम लीलो प्रयोगी ए सुंदर हो ए जगते तितनी माया बलम निजे जो माया बहुत प्रकाशित करवा जन्म जो माया ही एक जगत के उरूप प्रकट भी लाते हो केव कृष्ण एकदम मधु दर्शन करते पारे कपन दर्शन करे जो माया एक जगत समेत एक तो संबंध पर है तपन जगत के रूप में सत्य पारे तई उठ पर्यंत बोचन जैसे निजे देखे निजे के मुक्त हो जाए छे ओ कथा अभी बार बार बोले छी जे कृष्ण बाल्य काले ते अपनी माखन मिश्री लिए खेते खेते स्तंभ के धरे खुद पर कछे आ तार छाया देखे मने कछे ते बे सुंदर एकदम मार सभा आमी आज पर्यंत के देखी नहीं এটাকে একটা মিত্র করবার জন্য বন্ধু করবার জন্য তাকে মাখন মিশ্রী দিচ্ছে সেই রূপে দিচ্ছে বারবার ইনি দিচ্ছেন আর ও ছায়াতে দিচ্ছে তখনই না একটু রাগ একটা খুব বন্ধন গুলকি দিয়েছেন আর তাতে বহু নাকে এইরকম করছে আজ শুধু আমার দেখে ওইখান থেকে হাসছে যদি মন্থন করতে তখন লজ্জিত আরে এই তো আমার ছায়া বস মায়ের কোলে দিয়ে আতার অঞ্চল দিয়ে যে কেটেলি লেন যে সদামা উঠা কে অঞ্চল বা সুন্দর তৈ তিনি যে দর্শন করে দিয়ে অত্যন্ত মুগ্ধ হয়ে যায় আর তিনি চিন্তান করেন আমার এই রূপ সবচেয়ে বেশি কেশ সৌন্দর্য পান করে আসে তখন যাহা কৃষ্ণের প্রতি ওই প্রেম অন্য অত্যন্ত উজ্জ্বল ভাবেতে আছে কার মধ্যে শ্রীমতীকে এই যে মহাভাব মহাভাব পরে মাধব মোদন ইত্যাদি যার ভাব আছে তারা এই রূপকে আস্বাদন করতে পেয়েছে এই জন্য রাধিকে রাধিকার মতনই আমাকে নিজেকে ভোগ করবার জন্য তার প্রিয়া হওয়াতে শিষ্য সচিনন্দন গৌতম এত সুন্দর মধুর এইটা হচ্ছে তার পরিবার কিরকম পরিকার বার কিরকম পরিকার গল বর্গে উৎকর্ষে যত উন্নত হবে আরাধ্য দেব তত উন্নত হবে এদের অপেক্ষা হনুমানের বৈশিষ্ট্য এর জন্য হনুমানের আরাধ্য রামচন্দ্রের এই নারায়ণ থেকে উৎকর্ষ এ থেকে উৎকর্ষ উদ্ধব অক্রূর ইত্যাদি ব্রজবাসী অর্জুন ইত্যাদি এই জন্য দ্বারকাধীশের উৎকর্ষ বেশি আর তদপেক্ষা ব্রজেতে সখাগণের সঙ্গে যখন কৃষ্ণ খেলাধুলা ইত্যাদি করছেন তখন ওই এই শ্লোকটা আছে এইখানে তার সকলের সে উৎকর্ষ করলাম তার সঙ্গে খেলাধুলা করছে লিখেও খাওয়া দাওয়া ইত্যাদি করছে এই পরিকর বৈশিষ্ট্য আর যে সদা মায়ের কাছে তখন তাকে তখন বলতে কেউ উৎকর্ষ আর গোপী সমাজকে তখন তিনি আর মনমত ওইখানে তো এখানে তে বলছেন যে কি পরিকর গোকুলে গোকুলে মানে গো গোপী গোধান গোপাস্ত নন্দ যশোদা আর সব এই হচ্ছে পরিকর এই পরিকর বৈশিষ্ট্যের জন্য অন্য সমস্ত আরাধ্যগণ থেকে তার উৎকর্ষ ব্রাজমান পরিকর ব্রাজমান স্থান বিশেষ পূর্ব হইতে পূর্ব পূর্ব লীলা হইতে উৎকর্ষ বিশেষ প্রকাশের দ্বারা অথবা গোকুলেরই স্বাভাবিক শোভা বিশেষ দ্বারা তিনি শোভমান রাজমান শোভিত হচ্ছে কোথায় গোকুলে সেই জন্য বলছে যোগ্য স্থান পুরপুর লীলা পুরপুর মানে এই যে বর্ণন করলাম ও থেকে গোকুলের মাহাত্ম্য বেশি শোভমান ওইখানে সুশোভিত হচ্ছেন অথবা ধামীকেই সুশোভিত করছেন অথবা ধাম সুশোভিত করছে এখানে বলতে প্রভু ধাম সবসময় মনে রাখ অসম বসন দূষণ যা কিছু বলতে প্রভু কৃষ্ণ থেকে অভিন্ন অতএব সব সচিদানন্দময় ধাম যেরকম অলঙ্কার দূষণ বসন সব কিছু দূতাই অর্থ হবে প্রথমে অর্থ হয়েছে সে এরা সুশোভিত করছে কৃষ্ণকে, আবার কৃষ্ণ সুশোভিত করছেন তাহলে দুটাই অর্থ। দশম স্কন্ধেতে বর্ণন করা হয়েছে কি চকাশ ভূমি পরিষদগত অর্চিত ত্রৈলোক্য লক্ষ্মীক পদম বহু দধত। এখানে সব থেকে গোপীগণের পার্শ্বদত্ত পরিকরত্ত এর বৈশিষ্ট্য বলা হচ্ছে কি চকাশ ভূমি কৃষ্ণ হওয়ার পরে জয়কীতি অধিকম ইত্যাদি দ্বারা তারা বিরহ কীর্তন করতে 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 কৃষ্ণ আর থাকতে পারলেন না, তখন প্রকৃত হল তখন কিছু লজ্জি কিছু মন্দ মুস্কান এরকম নানা ভাব নিয়ে আর গোপীগণের পরিষদের উপরে তাদের কুমকুম রঙ্গি কি বলে উত্তরী অবসানের উপরে এক একটি এক এক জাতি গোপী এক একটি রচিত সেটি আসনের তার বিষয়ে বৈশিষ্ট্য কি ওই আসনের বৈশিষ্ট্য কি কুমকুম দ্বারা রঞ্জিত গোপীগণের সিংহের দ্বারা কুমকুম দ্বারা অথবা কৃষ্ণ চরণের দেবী কুমকুম আর পুঁতে লেগেছে ওইটাকে আর তাতে অত্যন্ত সুন্দর মর্মত মর্মত রূপ তিনি ধারণ করে গোপীগণের পরিষদে। তখন এক রকমের গোপী কৃষ্ণের পদ আমরা তার পিছিয়ে যশোদা মায়ের পিছিয়ে আমরাও নারায়ণ কৃষ্ণকে ধরবার জন্য তো এই জন্য আজকে আমরা এখানে থেকে সামান্য ভাবেতে কিছু কি বলে জল খাওয়া করে এখনই রেডি আছে সব কিছু ভোগ লেগে গেছে আর ওখানে যে আর কিছু খেয়ে আর তারপরে আমরা এখানে থেকে যাব কালিয়াতে ওখানে গিয়ে তোমরা সবচেয়ে প্রথমে যাবে ওই প্রবোধানন্দ সরস্বতী ভজন কুটি আর সমাধি পাশে যমুনা ধারে ওই কালিয়াতের উপরে বিল্বা মঙ্গল ঠাকুর ভজন স্থলী যেখানে 700 বছর পর্যন্ত প্রতীক্ষা করতেছিলেন তারপরে বল্লভাচার্যকে তাহার বিচারধারা তাকে প্রদান করে তারপরে কৃষ্ণ যেখানে লম্ফ দিয়ে হ্রদেতে কালী হ্রদেতে লম্ফ দিয়েছেন তার মধ্যে সেই খালে তারপরে তে সনাতন গোস্বামীর ভজন কুটি আর ওইখানে তার সমাধি গ্রন্থ সমাধি ইত্যাদি দর্শন করে তার আরাধ্যে মদন মোহন যেখানে তিনি প্রতিষ্ঠা করেছিলেন পাশেইতে মদন মোহন তার প্রতিভূতি গুলো যেখানে রয়েছে ওইটাকে ওটাই দর্শন করে আর তারপরে অদ্বৈত বট ওটাকে নিত্যানন্দ বট বলে আবার অক্ষয় বট বলে বহু পুরনো কৃষ্ণ লীলার সময়কার আর সেখানে মদন মোহন ছিলেন কিছুদিন ওইখানে প্রথমে মদন গোপাল আর তারপরে অষ্টসখী আর তারপরে চলার পর গলি দান গলি মান গলি প্রেম গলি কুঞ্জ গলি এইসব গলি হয়ে এখান থেকে চলে আসে যারা দর্শন করতে চায় ওই বাঁকে বিহারীকে তারা যেতে পারে তবে আমরা খোল মৃদঙ্গ ইত্যাদি না নিলে আমরা যেতে পারি না দণ্ড পর্যন্ত তারা যে কিরকম বৈষ্ণব আমরা বুঝতে পারি আর যেখানে রাধারানী নাম ওখানে যে কি রাধারানী যেখানে প্রকট রূপে নাই মুকুট আর কি ভাবে তারা রাখে সেখানে আমাদের দর্শনের যেখানে রাধারানী একেলা আছে সেখানে যাব কিন্তু একেলা কৃষ্ণ আছে রাধারানীকে ছেড়ে দিয়ে ওই কৃষ্ণের সঙ্গে আমাদের আমরা তো ওই রস চাই না যশোদা মাইয়াকে প্রণাম করে কিন্তু সুন্দর আনুগত্য না আনুগত্য যেখানে যশোদা মাইয়াকে সুয়া ছেড়ে দিয়ার ওইখানে
Hare Krishna, attention please. Some devotee has requested me for initiation. Whoever wants initiation, they can contact with me for PM and they can register their name. কিছু ভক্ত দ্বারা হরিনাম দীক্ষার জন্য অনুরোধ করেছেন তার আজ বিকাল 4টার সময় আমার সঙ্গে যোগাযোগ করে নাম লেখাতে পারেন Some devotees have requested me for initiation. Whoever wants initiation, they can contact with me 4 p.m. and they can register their name. Day after tomorrow, the appearance day of Radha Kundal. Day after tomorrow, initiation just after class. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. We left at a point of Krishna's beauty. How much beautiful he is. That his beauty is not dependent upon any ornaments or anything else from external side. His beauty is so natural and high class that ornaments get ornamented when they come closer to Krishna. How much beautiful is further according to the verse? I told that Gurudev has quoted a verse. This verse is, it is the time of Sharad Purnima. Krishna prayed over flute and he called all the gopis of Braj. And these gopis came running from their house, leaving everything. When they came in front of Krishna, Krishna is smiled and jestfully said, "Oh, you have come. Good. Now you should go back." Go back? Why should we go back? Krishna is explaining, "Gopis, you have come midnight here, it's not good." The religion of gopis. What is the religion of gopis? Of female. Female religion is that they should go back to their husbands. They should serve their husbands. Serving their husband is the true religion of gopi, female, feminine religion. It may be so that husband may be lame, he may be ill, he may be sick, he may be crippled. But the religion of female is that she should serve her husband. You have come here. Okay, nice. But now you go back. It's not good for you. It is not good on your part that you have given up your husband and come here to me. Then what gopis are replying? That shows the beauty of Krishna. Gopis are saying, "Oh Krishna, you are having such a nice and rude, such a beauty, such a beautiful characteristic that not only we sentimental wretched women of this Braj, but all the Tribhuvan, you know Tribhuvan, all the universes in the transcendental abode and in this material abode, they are attracted by your beauty and on the top of it by your flute melody of your flute. They are attracted by your..." How much are they attracted? Attraction is not a meager attraction. So intense attraction that each and every living entity forget its dharam, forget its characteristic. They start behaving otherwise. When you play over flute, what happens? Deer comes near to you. Those who are always afraid of human beings, they come near to you. They forget their own religion. They forget their own characteristic. Not only this, even trees, they give up their religion. And inanimate things on the top of it, like flowing yamuna, water, it becomes hard. And a stone, it melts. When each and everything is giving up its religion, here religion, in English religion means faith, but here when we call it dharma, dharma means intrinsic characteristic of the thing, nature. So everything, even inner things, those non-living things, they give up their nature. What to speak of we wretched women? Not only this thing, Narayan is himself God and his wife is Lakshmi. She is also having a desire to associate with you and she is giving up Narayan and coming to have your association. So you are putting blame on us. We are not to be blamed. It is you and your beauty and your flute who is to be blamed. What can we do? This shows the beauty of Krishna. And on the top of it, Uddhav, Gurudev has cited a verse. Uddhav is saying, Krishna is so much beautiful. How much? That he himself get enticed by his own beauty. When he saw himself in the on the wall where there was mirror-like jewel and he saw his own image, oh, he was so much attracted towards it. He started giving him butter. And the image is also giving him butter. Then he just smiled. Then image also smiled. Then he is giving gurki, what you call bandar gurki. He is, what does monkey does?
More.
So, nervous, okay. So, when these things take place, that Krishna is himself getting attracted towards his own beauty, but to speak of Gopi. And on the top of it, Gurudev is explaining his beauty, that his beauty is really enjoyed by themselves, Gopis. And on the top of it, Radharani. So, Krishna is so much beautiful. After describing the intense beauty of Krishna, now Parikar Vishesh. Parikar Vishesh means the characteristic and speciality of the associates of Krishna. Krishna's devotees and associates are seeing Krishna according to their own mood and bhav. When Hanuman sees Krishna, he sees him in the form of Ram. And when Jai Vijay, they see Krishna, they see in the form of Narayan. So, the worshipable deity of Hanuman, Ram, has got its own special characteristics than the worshipable deity of Jai Vijay, that is Narayan. Similarly, the worshipable deity of Arjun, that is Dwarkadish, has higher speciality and characteristic than worshipable deity of Hanuman. And gradually, the Yashoda Ma, when seeing Krishna in such a high beauty, she is running after Krishna. Krishna is scared of Yashoda Ma. This beauty of Krishna is so high class beauty. And when gopis are seeing Krishna, they are from their point of view, Krishna is how much beautiful. Then Gurudev gave that example that when Krishna disappeared from Ras dance and then again he is reappearing in Ras dance, and at that time his countenance, his position, his style, his gait, his everything is so beautiful that he is manmat, and he is real beautiful. Beauty as it is really is reflected in Krishna at that time. And all those gopis are so much attracted to him, they are giving their this Uttariya to make an asana for Krishna to sit, which is smeared with kumkum. And what is kumkum, Gurudev is also explaining by some hints only. And one gopi has taken Krishna's feet in her lap. One is holding his arm and one is just taking the cute beetle of Krishna, Tambul, and one gopi from a distance shooting an arrow of sly glance on him and complaining that we have come here giving up our everything for you and you are making such a you are disappearing and you are trying to tease us in this way. And who is she? She is Radharani. Seeing Krishna, to her, the beauty she adopts is the highest class of beauty. This is the beauty Vaishishtha. Now comes the Leela Vaishishtha, which Gurudev will explain tomorrow. Leela Vaishishtha means his pastime. Go ahead, everyone.
At first, he is to go to take some breakfast, and after that, go to Yasoda. Then, Karyadhar.